Hello everyone, we will be starting with the module 4, which comprises of network layer protocols and unicast routing protocols. So first let us see about the network layer protocols. Here we will be studying about a IPv4 protocol, which is an internet protocol version 4, and then we'll be moving on to ICMPv4, which is auxiliary protocol, which is an internet control message protocol, followed by we'll be studying mobile IP, that is in the first half of the module, that is network layer protocol, followed by in the unicast routing protocols we'll be studying about distance vector algorithm, then Dijkstra algorithm, path vector routing. So here in the first section, which discusses the IPv4 protocol, here we'll be studying about the IPv4 datagram format. Then what is the purpose of fragmentation? In the next class we'll be studying that, and also the option fields, their purpose in a datagram, and finally we look into the security issues. And the second section, which discusses about the ICMPv4, which is one of the auxiliary protocol which is used in the network layer. Already we have seen it in the module 1, which helps IPv4. So it is internet control message protocol. First, briefly discusses the purposes, and then also we'll see how this can be used as a debugging tool and also check some calculation. Then we'll be moving on to the mobile IP. So first let us start with the network layer protocols. So the network layer in version 4 can be thought of as one main protocol, and then there are three auxiliary protocols. The main protocol, which is IPv4, is responsible for packetizing, forwarding and delivery of a packet at the network layer. So the ICMPv4, this helps IPv4 to handle some errors that may occur in the during the delivery of the packet, and followed by it we have a IGMP protocol, which is internet group management protocol. It is used to help IPv4 in multicasting, and which is something like sending the information to many users, that is multicasting. And ICMP4 is something like control message protocol, handle the errors that may occur in the delivery, that is in case if it is a message failure, message is not delivered, all that will be intimated. And ARP is used in address mapping, which glues the network and the data link layer, and also it maps the IP address to the MAC address, or the network layer address to the link layer address, which is already we have seen in the earlier modules. Now here in the figure, what we can see is the position of different protocols. We can see here IP is in the network layer, which is at the center, which is said to be the main protocol, and for which we have those auxiliary protocols, which are IGMP, ICMP and ARP. So it is internet group management protocol, internet control message protocol and address resolution protocol. All these are the auxiliary protocols, which you can see, which are shown in the little smaller blocks, which tells that those are the auxiliary protocols. Then in the subsequent modules, we'll see about the transport layer protocols, which is in the module 5. Next is about the datagram format. So the IPv4, which is an internet protocol version 4, is an unreliable datagram protocol, which is said to be an unreliable datagram protocol. It provides a best effort delivery service. The meaning is that the packets can be corrupted, or packets can be lost, or they might be delayed, or maybe the thing is that packets might arrive out of order, and these might create congestion in the network. But IPv4 tries to provide a best effort delivery service. It is said to be unreliable, and if reliability is needed, then we have to have IPv4 paired with the TCP or UDP, which is in the upper layers, which is in the transport layer. It is something like a post office. We can see in the post office, it tries its level best to deliver the letters. If an unregistered letter is lost or damaged, then the sender and the receiver are responsible for that to discover what has happened. If it is registered, it will be delivered properly. Something similar to that is IPv4 protocol. It is a connectionless protocol. Already we have seen that connectionless protocols, these uses datagram approach. Connectionless in the sense the messages are connectionless, I mean the packets or the frames. Here in the case of a network layer, those are said to be the datagrams which are not related to each other, or these follow different routes to reach the destination, and also the frames are not related. That means there is no connection in between those frames, and they can arrive out of order at the destination. That is what the connectionless is. So the packets those are used by these internet protocol are called as datagrams. So we can see in the next slide, the figure of the IPv4 datagram format. The datagram is a variable length packet. It is a packet which is variable length, consisting of two parts. So this IPv4 defines the format of the packet, in which the data coming from the upper layer, that is the transport layer, are encapsulated as datagram at the network layer. So this datagram is a variable length packet which consists of two parts. So one is said to be the header and the other is said to be the payload. Payload is nothing but the data. Remember that the header is 20 to 60 bytes in length. So minimum the header length should be 20 bytes. And by adding up the options, it can go up to 60 bytes. So it contains the information essential to routing and delivery. So it is customary to in TCP/IP to show the header in 4 byte sections. So header is shown in 4 byte sections. So the header, which is 20 byte, it is shown as 4 byte section in 5 layers. So it is 5 into 4 byte will be 20 bytes. If there is extra options, they can be up to 40 bytes. So all together, the header is 20 to 60 bytes in length. So we can see a IP datagram here. So first is the IP datagram, which consists of a header, which is 20 to 60 bytes, and the rest is the payload, which is added, which can go up till 65,535 bytes. Now let us concentrate only on the header part, which is told now 20 bytes. Without the options, it has to be 20 bytes and minimum 20 bytes. In case if the receiver receives the IP datagram with the header which is less than 20 bytes, that means it is the corrupted datagram. So in that 20 bytes, we can see here there are 5 different layers, I mean the 5 different rows, and each row is of 4 byte. So 4 into 5 is 20 bytes. So 4 byte, each row is 4 byte, so which is subdivided different with respect to the number of bits it occupies. So first let us see about the VER. First VER, which is 4 bits, which is just half byte. 1 byte is 8 bit. So VER, which is only 4 bits, which tells about the version, and it has to be always 4. So it is 0100, because it is IPv4. Next, let us see about the header length. So this header length, which is 4 bits, so here what we do is the total length divided by 4 will be inserted here. This value will be total length divided by 4. So whatever is the header length, if we want to get, this will be multiplied by 4 to get that length. Okay, which will be seen later when we solve the problems. So however, remember that this 4 bits multiplied by 4, we get the total length of the header, excluding the payload. Next is, actually this header length, actually why it has, this has to be specified as, the receiver needs to know when exactly the header stops and the payload starts. Like, it should not mistaken the header as the payload. Payload is the data. Header is just like, as we have to the letters, when if we are placing it inside an envelope, onto the envelope we add those destination address, source address, all that. That is nothing but the header information here. So that will be the header information, which should not be mistaken that with the payload. So this header will be just 4 bits. So 4 into 4, that will give you the total length of that header. Okay. Now, service type. So service type is a 8 bit. It tells about how the datagram should be handled. Okay. About that, you'll be studying it further. Next is about the total length. So this total length, which is 16 bits, which tells about the header plus data in bytes. So this is like a receiving device should know when a packet has completely arrived. So this tells you about the total length of that full datagram. So in order to get just the length of the data, we have to subtract from this total length the header length multiplied by 4. So this header length multiplied by 4 will be the header total length of the header. Whatever we have this header length specified, multiplied by 4. Since we cannot insert full information, we are dividing it by 4 and then we are inserting only 4 bits. So this header length multiplied by 4, if we subtract it from the total length, which is in the 16 bits, header gets cancelled. So the remaining will be the length of the payload or length of the data. So this is required, as we need to know, because as padding may be added, because in the Ethernet protocols there is a condition for the maximum and minimum restrictions on the size of the data during the encapsulations. It has to be 46 to 1500 bytes. So if the size of the datagram is less than the 46 bytes, then the padding is added. So when the datagram is decapsulated, needs to check that total length field to determine how much is data and how much is the padding added. That is about the total length field. So just remember that to get the length of the data or the payload, we have to subtract the header length from the total length. This header length is HLEN, that field 4 bit content multiplied by 4 will give you the header length. So that HLEN multiplied by 4 has to be subtracted from total length to get the payload length or the data length or the length of the data. Next is about the identification flags. Identification flags, fragmentation offset, all these are related when the size of the datagram is larger than the network that can carry. In that case, we fragment it, that means we divide it and then transfer. That we'll be seeing it in the next class about the fragmentation. Next is about the time to live. So this time to live, it tells, it is just used to control the maximum number of hops visited by the datagram. That means when a source host sends, or the source device sends a datagram, it stores this number in that time to live field. And each router which processes this datagram decrements this number by one. So router keeps decrementing this. If it's zero, that means router discards the datagram. That means only till that duration of time this datagram should be active. So it controls the maximum number of hops visited by the datagram. Hops are nothing but here routers. So it can be alive only till there. Later it should not be transferred in the network. Next is about the protocol, which is an 8-bit field. The datagram can carry packet belonging to any transport layer protocol. So it can carry a packet which is belonging to UDP or TCP protocol. So datagram can also carry a packet from other protocol, like auxiliary protocol, which uses the services of this IP protocol. And when payload is encapsulated in the datagram at the source, the corresponding this protocol field should be inserted. So when datagram arrives at the destination, when it reaches that destination, this field is checked, and because of which the protocol, to which protocol this data should be delivered, the information can be obtained. That is about the protocol field. So multiplexing takes place at the source and demultiplexing takes place at the destination. Then is about a header checksum. To check the header, we'll be solving the problems related to it. To check the header, it is used, not the data. Header checksum is just to check the header. Here, checking of the data is not performed at the network layer. As we have already told, it is a connectionless, it is a unreliable. There is no control methods, and IP is not a reliable protocol. It does not check whether the data carried is corrupted during the transmission, all that. It has to be checked by the protocols that owns this payload, maybe UDP, TCP, all such protocols. And IP header information, it checks only the IP header information, if the destination IP address is corrupted or packets can be delivered, because of which the packets can get delivered to the wrong destination, or if protocol field is corrupted, then in that case payload may be delivered to a wrong protocol, or if there is a fragmentation is corrupted, then in that case when the datagram is fragmented, it will be numbered. If it gets corrupted, then the datagram cannot be reassembled at the destination. Thus, internet protocol adds checksum field to check the header. Remember, this checksum is used to check only the header, not the payload or the data. Next, we have source IP address. So this source IP address, which is a 32-bit address, which defines the IP address, value of this field as well as the destination IP address should not get changed during when this datagram travels from source to destination. Next, we have the options and the padding. So datagram header can have up to 40 bytes of options, which are used for network testing and debugging. Those will be the 40 bytes. So next we have something like payload. Header is over payload. Payload is the main reason for creating this datagram. Payload is nothing but the data. So packet coming from the other protocol that use the services of the IP. So that is a payload. So payload which comes from the other protocol and which uses the services of IP, it is converted as datagram. Next is datagram is this can be said as just as a postal package. Like payload will be the content of the package, and the header information is just like the address which is written on the package, which is already we have given that example. So here you can see multiplexing and the demultiplexing using the value of the protocol field. So there are different values are given to the protocol field. As we have already seen that datagram can carry a packet from the other protocols. Like it can carry a packet which belongs to the maybe TCP IP, or it can carry a packet belonging to internet control message, which are the auxiliary protocols, internet group management protocols, all that. So with respect to that, these are the field values which should be, protocol values which should be entered: 01 for ICMP, 2 for IGMP, 6 for TCP, 17 for UDP, OSPF, which we'll be seeing it later, one of the routing protocol, 89. So these has to be protocol field, this value should be inserted. The multiplexing takes place at the transmitter side, and deep multiplexing will takes place at the receiver side. This is about the IP datagram format. Usually this question appears in the VTU question paper. So you have to tell about very important thing you have to remember is it is an unreliable protocol, which is a connectionless protocol. It provides best effort delivery service. If reliability is needed, it has to be paired with the TCP, which is at the higher upper layers. And about the datagram format, you have to remember about the different fields. This contains the information which is essential to routing and delivery. This consists of 4-byte sections. So in that 4-byte sections, we have 5 rows, so altogether 20 bytes. So remember that the header should be minimum 20 bytes. If not, it will be a corrupted data, and it always in addition 40 options can be added, so it becomes 60 bytes. And to calculate the total length, always the total length will be the header length plus the payload length. So this header length is whatever data we enter into that field multiply by 4, because we enter it by dividing it by 4. So multiply that by 4, then we add with the payload, we get the total length. So in case if we want the length of the data, from the total length we have to subtract HLE and multiply it by 4. Okay, so all that we have seen. Now let us see one example here. An IPv4 packet has arrived in the first 8 bits as this. The receiver discards the packet Y. Here, first 8 bits, we know that. First 4 bits is a version. Next 4 bit, which will tell about header length. So HLEN. So version is 4, however. So it is 0100, which you can see first 4 bits. Next bits, which is 0010, which tells it is 2. So whatever is entered in HLEN, if you multiply it by 4, that will be the header length, which we get it as 8. But it is invalid because the minimum number of bytes in the header must be 20, because it has to have, in that header length we have version, there are specific bits there, and it is 4 byte multiplied by 5, it has to be minimum 20 bytes. So the receiver discards the packet because packet is corrupted in the transmission. Let us see the second example. Here, in an IPv4 packet here, the value of header length is 1000, which means it is 8. So how many bytes of options are carried by this packet? Since the header value is 8 here, which means the total number of bytes in the header is 8 into 4, that means 32 bytes. So the first 20 bytes are the base header, and the next 12 bytes are the options. So we have 32 bytes, only header can be up to 20, so the 12 are the options. Next is the third example. In an IPv4 packet, value of the header length is 5 and the value of the total length field is 0028 in hexadecimal. How many bytes of data are being carried by this packet? Since the HLEN, that is header length, is 5, that means we have the total number of bytes in the header is 5 into 4, which is 20 bytes. Total length field is 0028, which is in hexadecimal, which we convert it into decimal, it is 40 bytes. So 40 byte is the total length, header length is 20. So when we subtract that, we get it as 20 bytes, that is nothing but the data. So here there are no options. Total length field is 40 bytes, which means the packet is carrying 20 bytes of data. Next, the fourth example. The IPv4 packet has arrived with the first few hexadecimal digits. These are the digits. How many hops can this packet travel before being dropped? And the data belong to what upper layer protocol? So if we see that datagram, if we look back to the datagram, we can see that to find out how many hops it can travel, it will be dependent on time to live. So here you can see that the first 1 byte, which will be version and header length, next 1 byte is service type, next 2 bytes are total length, so 4 bytes are over, next 2 bytes are identification, 6 bytes are over, next we have flags fragmentation, so 8 bytes are over. After 8 byte we get time to live, and after the 9th byte we get the protocol. Now let us apply that here. in the problem. So this is in hexadecimal, so two digits will comprise of one byte. So it is 45 first byte, then second, third, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After the 8th byte, we have time to live. So it is 01 is the value. So it is in which is the 9th byte, which is 01. This means the packet can travel only one hop. Next is the protocol field, which is 02, which means that the upper layer protocol is IGMP. As it was told, for IGMP, the protocol value is 2. Next, let us, which was discussed here, if you want, we can go back here. It is told IGMP, the protocol value is 2, which has to be inserted there. Next is checksum calculation for a IPv4 header without options. Here, header is divided into 16-bit sections. All are added and the sum is complemented after wrapping the leftmost digit, and the result is inserted in the checksum field. That is how the checksum is calculated. So here the wrapped calculation, wrapped sum and the checksum can also be done as follows. So here see an example. So how the checksum is calculated. So it is a datagram format which consists of here header. So 4 is the version, 5 is nothing but the header length, 0 is the service type, and 28 here we have the total length. So this 4, 5 and 0 each bytes, so here 2 bytes are written here, 4500, it's 28 and written as hexadecimal 001c. Next we have 49,153 in hexadecimal, it is written as C001. You can check it. 49,153 in hexadecimal is C001. Next is 00417, and checksum is this field which has to be filled next. So initially it will be written as 0 itself. Next 10, 12, 14, 5 source and the destination addresses all are written where 2 byte values are written. So since it is 2 bytes, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, you will get 10 rows. So it is added up, then it is wrapped, that means 1 is added to the LSP, and then to get the checksum, we take the complement of it and that will be inserted here. That is how the checksum is calculated. So in the next class, we will be moving on to the fragmentation concepts, followed by it ICMPv4 protocol, then the mobile IP. This is about the network layer protocols.